Hey guys, what's up? In this video, I'm gonna talk to you guys about some modifications that you can do to your 4Runner, Tacoma, or really any rig for $100 or less. Now, I would say that my truck is pretty close to being done modded, and a lot of these were pretty expensive, but that took me years to do. So if you're pretty new to it, or you just wanna get some mods that are pretty cheap, look into this list because I think that these are very helpful and you guys will notice a huge difference. So the first one that I'm going to recommend to you guys is a rubberized floor mat. Now this is really going to be something I recommend for any off-road vehicle, because if you're going to be doing any off-roading, camping, you know, snowboarding, hiking, anything like that, you're going to be tracking mud back in the car. Pretty much every vehicle that I've ever owned, I've gotten either WeatherTech or something rubberized. There's actually a lot of brands now that are a lot cheaper because I know the WeatherTech are pushing sometimes $200. So you might want to check out these. These are $100 and they are really good. I've heard great things about them. A lot of people I know are running these, and I think that they're going to make a huge difference for your 4Runner, Tacoma, or really any off-road rig. So my next recommendation is going to be especially for the 4Runners and Tacomas, because I honestly hate the way the storage is set up in the side pocket and glove box, and especially here in the armrest here, because it's just basically a giant hole. It's really deep, and if you really stack it up, then stuff just gets buried and you got to dig everything out. So that's why I bought this right here, which holds a lot of different things. You got, I can put my keys, this stuff right here. You've got coin holders there. I've definitely underutilized this, but it really helps because I can keep the stuff down here, like my winch controller stuff down in there. And then on top, I can just put that in there. And I've got my stuff that I need to grab right away, like sunglasses, keys, you know, hand sanitizer, stuff like that. And it really helps a lot. Now, one thing I haven't gotten that I really do want to get is an organizer for this section in here. I've got a lot of napkins and just junk and deflators and stuff like that in here, but they make one that goes in here like that, and you can kind of separate things out. So funny enough, as I was editing this, I actually found a deal with the part that I was talking about, this organizer for the glove box. It's extra one, and yeah, there you see. And this is what I'm talking about here. It's a nice little organizer, but I actually found all three for $45. That is a great deal. I know somebody that's using that right now, and they've told me that you really should be running that because it really helps organize this. So there's also another one. There's this one right here, which is not very deep. And I do like to keep my radio in there sometimes. If you're off-roading, it'll fall out. So there's another one that kind of goes in here, and it's an insert that's rubber. I think that that's a really, really good route to go, and I think I will be doing that. But yeah, there's also tons of different options that I haven't personally tried, but I've seen on Amazon, and I will probably be trying a lot of them in the future just because I think that's the nature of this channel. But yeah, like cargo nets, stuff like that. So I'll link a bunch of those below. I can't recommend the ones I haven't tried, but a lot of them have really high ratings on Amazon, so that's a really good indicator of where the product sits in its quality. Now, another one I want to talk to you guys about that is pretty much purely aesthetic, but I think makes a big difference on the Tacomas and the 4Runners, it is just the blackout emblems. So I think that especially because I have a silver 4Runner, the emblems just didn't look very good on there, I don't think. And a lot of off-road mods are black. So like my sliders, my bumper, you know, the wheels, tires, stuff like that are all black. So I think that it really just looks a lot better. It kind of pops and stands out against the silver. I know it's just purely aesthetic, but I think that this is something that you can use to really kind of make your 4Runner, Tacoma, anything like that stand out. So I know they make them for a lot of different brands, and they have it for the off-road. I'm sure they have one for trail and SR5, anything like that.
and you can find them pretty cheap online. Like I said, I will link all of these below and you guys can find them on Amazon or wherever. I think that this is a really cool mod, and especially for the 4Runner, I know this is a little bit over the price range, but the Pro Grill kind of just seals it all together. But like I said, that's not going to be something that you find for under $100, but a nice little compliment to the emblems.
So if you don't want to buy the Blackout emblems, you can also buy Plasti-Dip and do it yourself. There's a few things on my truck I have Plasti-Dipped. If you're worried that it's not going to last, mine has lasted a long time, so you can just Plasti-Dip those. And a can of Plasti-Dip is pretty cheap, and you can hit all the emblems, and you can even do, you know, some other stuff on there if you want to paint something else. So that's also something that you could do for pretty cheap.
So the next one I'm going to recommend is these blind spot mirrors. These really cost about $5, and the amount of safety I think that they provide for you, or assurance that you're not going to hit somebody, I think it's way, way worth it. And you can put it on your driver's side and your passenger side, and you just adjust it a little bit and get it to where you know that you can see all the way around, and basically it completely eliminates a blind spot.
Now if you look here, this is exactly where I would be looking while I'm driving. So you see that you don't see anything there, and you may have a car right there. So that is this stand right here, which is about where a car might be. And honestly, like I said, you can't see it in this at all. I'm looking down at the ground, nothing. But as soon as you look right there,
maybe something could be about that tall, which would be a normal low car or something like that, and you would be able to see it. So another one I want to talk to you guys about is headlight upgrades. I haven't upgraded the housing from factory. I know you can do that for $400 or $500. So from the factory, these come with sort of a yellowish color bulb, and they're not very bright, but you can swap these out for LEDs in really any color you like. I would go with like a 5,000 Kelvin, which is what I've done with the headlights here and with this as well. So these are last fit as well as my fogs down here. These are white, but they switch to orange when you use the turn signal. So you actually get a lot of light out of this one, which I really do like. These are about as bright as each other, but when you turn, they turn orange because it's illegal to have a white turn signal. So this last one is a really cool light that goes from amber to white. So in the winter you can be in the amber, and then you can switch it to white whenever. All you have to do is turn that stock one time, and there you go. You're white now, and now you're amber. So when you're swapping out the LEDs, you can also swap out the license plate LED. You can swap out these as well as the ones back here. I haven't done that yet, but it's on my list of things to do. I just haven't gotten around to it, but it looks really cool, and it may add a little bit of brightness. Interior sometimes just looks a little bit dated, and something like that is a mod that'll kind of bring it into the 2020s. So the last thing I want to talk to you guys about is this trailer hitch right here. I paid, I think, $30 for this, and this is the point where your vehicle can tow from, so it's gonna have a pretty strong point to pull somebody out, or if you get stuck, to pull yourself out. I recommend this pretty much for anybody that has a trailer hitch. It's really just a good sense of security if you're wheeling, especially if you're wheeling in stuff like sand or snow. If you don't have a winch or anything like that, you're not gonna have the recovery points on the front. But as long as you have something on the back, it's definitely a lot better than having nothing. Because if you don't have that shackle on there, then really you don't have a great point to pull from. Now I do have a winch on the front, and I do have pretty much the same shackles right here. And that's basically my recovery point, so I could pull somebody if I wanted to, or get pulled if I don't want to use my winch.
So guys, I really consider this more of like a part one of a series that I want to do, but for the purposes of this video, that's all I'm going to recommend because that's all I've really tried. So if you have any other suggestions, please comment below because I'd like to go ahead and try out some new stuff. And I'm sure if you clicked on this video that you're probably looking for similar items. So maybe somebody in the comments could give you a new suggestion. If you like this video, leave me a like, and if you like what I'm doing here, consider subscribing. But really, that's it for me, guys, and I will see you guys in the next video.